And you're buying America. Let me give you a figure that'll blow your mind, I think.
So real quick, before we get back to the clip, I want to show you guys the background and Berkshire Hathaway's performance over the last 30 years. And you might be wondering that what we're about to listen to is why Berkshire Hathaway, and specifically Warren Buffett, is suggesting to invest in the S&P 500 over the long term, and why he's going to have his wife be invested in the S&P after he passes away. So that's coming from a guy who's run a company from the price of about $7,000 back in but the 90s to $430,000 at the date of recording. So that's what we're going to explore in this clip. I'll give some commentary in the end as to my thoughts.
So I want to ask a little bit about some of the new investing things going on in the markets. And Greg Wondra from Bakersfield wonders about target date funds. And I wanted to also ask about all the new index funds with a brain. Are those things really adding value?
No, probably not. The S&P 500 index fund is the one to use. That's the one I used in that bet I made for 10 years. It's the one I've told the trustee for my wife to put 90% of the funds I leave her into. The S&P 500 is, I don't know whether it's 80% of the market value of, you know, of everything you can buy in this country. And it's over, I think it's over 20 trillion. And you're buying America. And let me give you a figure that'll blow your mind, I think. I bought my first stock when I was 11 years old. It was the first quarter of 1942, shortly after Pearl Harbor. I spent $114.75, three shares, $114.75. If I put that 114 into the S&P 500 at that time and reinvested the dividends, think of a figure as to what it might be, would be worth today.
Oh, man.
Well, it's, okay, you know, but I just want your audience to think for a second.
Okay,
the answer, the answer is about $400,000.
Oh.
So if I, as a little kid, had taken that 114 bucks I'd saved on shoveling snow or whatever I'd done, $400,000 today, one person's lifetime, that's America. I mean, that isn't me. You know, it is the huge tailwind the American economy gives to any equity investor. Now, the market's gone down many times during that time. People have panicked during that time. Headlines have been terrible. You know, it looked like we were losing the war when we first bought it. But America is a powerful economic machine that since 1776 has worked, and it's going to keep working. Now, you don't want to buy to hold for a year. You don't want to buy with the idea that you can sell it in 2 years or 3 years necessarily make money. You could lose money that way. But if you buy it for 10, 20, just keep buying the S&P 500 index and forget about all the other nonsense that's being sold to you, because I'll guarantee you one thing about the stuff being sold to you, it will carry bigger fees than what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there's no reason to think that you're not, we don't know if it's 400,000, but that same sort of process or returns won't happen starting right now.
The S&P 500 companies have earned well over 10% on equity, often 15% annually for years and years and years and years. They've done it with Democratic administrations, with Republican administrations. Now, you get money compounding at that kind of rate underlying your investment, and you get a diversified group of that, I mean, you're going to do well.
So my take is that it's going to be hard to replicate Berkshire's performance. I mean, that sort of percentage return just isn't going to happen again with a company with a $646 billion market cap. That would take it to many trillions of dollars, which I just don't think is realistic. I think Berkshire's going to do well in the long term, and I do think it's like an index in and of itself that's going to perform and be safe. So in my opinion, putting some of your money in a stock like Berkshire is great, but that's the less risky part of your portfolio. That's the bond part of your portfolio that you might have if you're a young person not wanting to go into low yield bonds. So that's how I'm using Berkshire. I have exposure to it in my portfolio, I think probably about 5 to 10%, and a larger part of the portfolio, probably about 50%, is in index funds for the long run, just because that's going to automatically filter out, and the S&P 500 is also always going to have some of the greatest companies in the world. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to Intelligent Money Investing for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.